There is an old joke that has violinist Itzhak Perlman talking with a woman after a performance at Carnegie Hall. The woman says, "You play so beautifully, I would give my life to be able to play like that." Perlman replies, "Madam, I did." John was not a great musician, though he loved to sing. He was not a great artist of any kind, nor a successful businessman or an inspirational politician. In fact, few people can tell you what he did for a living. So what was it that John gave his life for? His music was of a different kind. For him, love was his instrument, life the orchestra in which he played, and the Beatitudes his score. So many people were fortunate to be in attendance for many of his performances. He performed at such places as St. Patrick's Soup Kitchen for senior citizens in the Cass Corridor, where he always took the jobs no one else wanted, scrubbing the huge metal pots and pans. He was featured at every hospital on the east side of Detroit, where he could be found visiting patients whose own families had forgotten about them, people John didn't even know. He befriended men and women who were in prison or down on their luck, unable to take care of themselves, offering them rides, companionship, clothing, food, mostly letting them know that they had a friend, despite what their past may have been. No one was too old, too sick, or too troubled for John. His performances could be seen at St. Vincent de Paul or the Capuchin Soup Kitchen, where he gathered and distributed clothing for people in need, or at the Our Lady Queen of Peace prayer group, where he welcomed strangers who were searching for a place to belong. He faced down angry men without using his powerful Marine Corps-trained fists, but with courage, forgiveness, and understanding. What kind of reviews did his performances receive? His favorite was the one he heard when he passed away. "Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me." His performances are forever recorded in the hearts of those who met and knew him.